Students, welcome to another session of dissection microscope. So we were discussing about dissecting microscope or stereo microscope. Dissecting microscope, we are also calling it as stereo microscope or stereoscopic microscope, and it is an optical microscope that is designed for low magnification observation of a specimen. So before going to the next topic, we'll discuss or refresh the stereo microscope once again. So what is stereo microscope? Stereo microscope or stereoscopic microscope is an optical microscope, and it is designed for log magnification observation of a sample. It uses the reflected light rays from the specimen surface instead of transmitted light rays, and it provides only a low magnification. So you can see here there are two eyepiece and two objectives here, and because of this it will give a 3D image, a three-dimensional image of the specimen rather than a flat image. And the magnification power of a dissecting microscope ranges from 5x to 80x. And these are the uses of stereoscopic microscope. A stereoscopic microscope is primarily used to view specimens like plants and animals, and it is useful when working with circuits and watches, and also it can be used for microsurgery, and it is used to view crystals. And these are the parts of stereoscopic microscope. It has two eyepiece, and the minimum magnification of the eyepiece is 10x. And a stereo head is there, and an objective is there, and stage plate is there for keeping the specimens, and the clips are the light controls, focus, and stereo head. And there are mainly three key parts or three components of the stereoscopic microscope. And first one, we can say viewing head or body. So this is the viewing head or body, and it consists of the optical components. So what are the optical components? Optical components are the eyepiece lenses and objective lenses. So the viewing head or body consists of these optical components. And next is focus block. And the third one is luminous stand. So luminous stand supports the microscope and it will provide illumination. So you can see here the illuminating lens in this luminous stand. And it provides a congestion purpose, that is, it has the stereoscopic microscope has increasing modular, and same head can be used in conjunction with the different focus blocks and stands. So there are three types of stands: pole stand, track stand, and one more stand is the boom stand. So in these stands we can use the same head, and that's why it provides conjunction purpose. And other parts are focus, working stage, stage clips, and transmitted illumination. Next we'll go on to the magnification of the stereoscopic microscope. So the total magnification power of a microscope or any normal microscope is the combination of the magnification of eyepiece and the magnification of objective lens. So likewise in stereo microscope also, the total magnification power of this microscope is referred as the combination of both magnification power of eyepiece and the objective lens. For example, we can say the eyepiece magnification is 4x and objective magnification is 10x. So what is the total magnification? Total magnification is equal to 4 into 10, 40x. So the total magnification of a stereoscopic microscope is the combination of magnification of eyepiece and magnification of the objective lens. And next is stereo microscope operating. So how we can operate a stereo microscope? So first of all, you have to set the microscope on a flat surface in a stable and comfortable position, and then you have to turn on the transmitter or oblique illuminator. So normally in a compound microscope we have to keep the microscope in the place where we'll get the sunlight, but in this stereo microscope the light source is already set in this microscopic base, so that you have to just turn on the transmitted or oblique illuminator. Then the third step is प्लेस ए स्मॉल सॉलिड स्पेसिमेन ऑन टू द स्टेज सच एज अ कार्ड कॉइन और एनी अदर फ्लैट डिटेल ऑब्जेक्ट दैट इज यू हैव टू कीप योर स्पेसिमेन ऑन द स्टेज एंड फिक्स इट यूजिंग द स्टेज क्लिप देन टर्न द मैग्निफिकेशन एडजस्टमेंट नॉब टू द लोवेस्ट पावर एंड ब्रिंग द इमेज इन टू द फोकस यूजिंग द फोकस कंट्रोल After that, you have to adjust the eyepiece for the correct interpupillary distance to suit you. So, everyone's focus will be different. So, you have to keep according to your interpupillary distance. And do this by moving the eyepiece closer together or farther apart until a single field of view is observed. And now, you can set the dioptropic adjustment rings on both eyepiece and keep the position to zero. So, here there is objective magnification. So you can keep this objective magnification according to your wish and then you can adjust the knob. Then use the magnification adjustment knob to set the highest magnification. After that, bring the image into focus with the focusing knob. So center the image on some clear point of detail on the specimen. So this is how we can operate a stereo microscope, and after that you have to adjust the microscope down to the lowest magnification using the magnification adjustment knob, and the image could be slightly out of focus. Then do not adjust the focus with the focusing knob and adjust the focus for each eye separately using the eyepiece. So in eyepiece there is a dioptric adjustment ring, so using that you can adjust your magnification according to your wish, and your microscope is now parafocal, and this means that as the microscope is zoomed from high to low magnification, the image will stay in focus throughout the entire image, and each individual will have the different settings. So according to your eye power, you can fix the magnification. And what are the specimens to be used in an stereoscopic microscope? So you can use an opaque, thick and solid specimens. Next is the type of stereo microscopes. So these are the types of stereo microscope. First one is stereo zoom dissecting microscope and stereo zoom boom stand microscope, then digital table dissection microscope, dual power dissecting microscope, single power stereo microscope, and single magnification handheld pocket microscope. So as I told earlier, there is a conjunction purpose in the microscope. So there are so many stands available, like zoom, I will show you here. So pole stand, track stand, and boom stand. So likewise, you can keep the head of the stereo microscope in any of these stands, and according to the stand used, there are so many types of stereo microscope. So first one is stereo zoom dissecting microscope. So it is a trinocular or binocular stereo microscope. This is the first one, stereo zoom dissecting microscope. It is a trinocular or binocular stereo microscope, and the zooming range is between 6.7x to 45x. So this is the zooming range, and it also contains a digital camera which captures photos of the viewing image. So we can record the image using the digital camera. And next is stereo zoom boom stand microscope. So it comes with larger stage and base, and it contains optional dual pipe lighting, and the magnification is 6x to 45x. So in stereo zoom boom stand microscope, the magnification is 6x to 45x. And next is digital table dissecting microscope. So it is high-end stereo microscope. Digital tablet dissection microscope contains a touch screen, LCD tablet, and a camera, and its magnification is 6.7x to 45x. And next one is dual power dissecting microscope, and this has a magnification of 10x to 30x, and it has 360 degree rotational ability also, and this also contains a high LED intensity light ring. And next one is single power stereo microscope, and it contains a magnification power of 10x to 40x, and it also contains diopter adjustments of 50 mm to 70 mm. And the last one is single magnification handheld pocket microscope. So this is a single powered handheld stereo microscope, and it has two magnification powers without any light. So these are the types of stereo microscope. And next is, what are the advantages of stereo microscope? So I told in the earlier session, it has two eyepieces and it has two objectives. Because of that, we can view in different angles. It's a specimen in different angles. That's why it will create, thus it will create a 3D image of the specimen. So this is the first advantage. It creates a 3D image of the specimen. And next one is, a stereo microscope is portable and easy to carry. So as you see in the picture, it's small and we can easily carry this one. And next is, the whole specimen can be observed using a stereo microscope. And the fourth one is, stereo microscope contain a digital camera which can record or capture the image. So in stereo microscope, as I said earlier, there are so many types of stereo microscope. So we can connect a digital camera and we can record the image of the specimen which we are viewing in the microscope. So stereo microscope contain a digital camera which can record or capture the image. So these are the advantages of using a stereo microscope. What is, first one is, it creates a 3D image. Why? Because it contains two eyepiece and two objectives. And a stereo microscope is portable and easy to carry. And the whole specimen can be observed using a stereo microscope. And stereo microscope contains a digital camera and which can use to record or capture the image. And next is, what are the disadvantages? So the disadvantage is saying that it is expensive and also, and it contains a low magnification power. So as we said earlier, it has a magnification power up to 80x. So it contains only low magnification power and it is highly expensive. That's why that is the disadvantage of this stereo microscope. So I hope you understood what is stereo microscope and what are the parts of stereo microscope and how stereo microscope is operating and the types of stereo microscope, the advantages and disadvantages. So if you have any doubts, you can clear. Thank you.